from Bareo, Sarawak, Malaysia.
Hi, I'm Jiaqi from Malaysia, and I'm a second year actuarial science student from Perak Board University, Malaysia.
My name is Rengganagi Adimulam. Actually, I'm Malaysian, local, and I'm actually running my own business called Sangeeta Holistic Kerala Ayurvedic Center. This is actually Indian traditional alternative medication. So I'm running this business for the past 4 years, and my business is located at Jalan Lipo, Kuala Lumpur.
To me, work-life balance is something like it's not new, but something that the work, besides being a mother, I a housewife, and in the church for the community. So it's something to just organize your time, my time to do all the responsibility, and to have the love to do the work.
Yeah, based on my personal opinion, work-life balance is something that prioritization between work and also life. How do we classify as work? Work actually is our ambitions and our career. Life is mainly towards our family, leisure, pleasure, and all our relaxation and all that. So when we come to certain stage that work-life balance is not in order, meaning to say that we never manage our time properly, we never prioritize our tasks, then work and life will be in balance. That's where we call there is no work-life balance. So we should actually manage our time properly, and also we have to prioritize our tasks, which is most important work that we need to do first compared to the least important. So I find that work-life balance is really important that we should achieve.
Rural communities also, I think like everywhere else, you need to have your schedule for all the plans, and what time or what day you're going to do it, and then you can know when to have it, like events being organized for the church, for the community, and so that it won't clash. But I think for most it would be the desire in my heart, the love and the love for the people, to upgrade the status of the ladies. Like we are going into modern technology and a lot of those, and we have to like be able to follow what the young people are doing, and to be able to get along and work together with the young people.
In the rural community of Malaysia, the challenge to actually achieve work-life balance is there, because the problem of some of the rural community here in Malaysia is that they don't have internet access. And like one of our campaign, Internet for All, without internet it is hard to achieve work-life balance. Not because like you need entertainment on the internet, not only, okay, it's one of the factor, but that's not entirely a factor. It's because like your job or opportunity, your option to further your studies, all available in the internet, especially if you are staying in a rural area, like let's say Bareo, Sarawak, where like you can only access to the big cities via plane.
Yes, we do. Because for me as a housewife, as a mother, I still can do my farm work, I still get involved with the church, and I still do community service. So it is part of life, even in the rural area.
personal opinion, I find that government should play an important role to implement certain rules in the country in order for the corporate sectors to follow. Because if you leave it individually, you know, in this 21st century, right, we are mainly in the, nuclear world. Because the reason being, everybody firefighting for achievements and also want to be the best. So normally the corporate, private corporate sectors, right, they will don't really follow the rules. They will actually ask the staff to work longer hours. And you see, I will say that in Malaysia, nowadays, there is no such thing that we work for 8 hours. Mainly, most of the staff, based on my earlier experience, work more than 8 hours, and sometimes they need to bring back the work to their home to follow up because the pressure, load, heavy load. So that's why there must be certain standard rules that the government should implement in order all the corporate sectors to follow. Otherwise, they will have their own way of doing things. And because for them is, if you want to work here, then you continue work. Otherwise, you find your own job. There is no standard procedures in that particular country. So I strongly believe that government playing an important role to implement certain rules for the corporate sectors is helpful for the staff in order to improve the work-life balance.
There is a saying that the youth, you are the pillar of the country. Youth, you will shape the future of the country. If the youth now are not concerned about work-life balance, what will become of our country in the future? Will we be robots that just keep working and working and working? Or will we prioritize life over work and just have fun, just party every day? Therefore, I think that we as youth, we have to be aware about work-life balance and prioritize which one is important and find the right balance between work and life.
From this conference, it really helped to give me an idea, or it opened my eyes to see more and deeper into it, knowing that it is not only for Malaysia, other ASEAN countries also have the same vision, the same problems also. And for us from Bahrain, it really helped that I have like 8 of us from Bahrain, and at last my friends know what I've been talking about all this while to them. It really helped.
As a youth, the way for me to help others achieve work-life balance is through example. Yes, I can just lead a life of work-life balance, like trying to balance between my family time, studies, extracurricular activity, and as well as time job, everything. Just set an example for everyone and practice what I preach.
I will strongly agree with this, especially on the non-government sectors. Based on my personal experience, as well as I heard from somebody, as just now I mentioned earlier, that because corporate sectors actually they are looking for productivity. They want to be the best, so they want to earn more money. So what they think that they are pressuring the staff to do more jobs, and also expecting the staff to work after the normal working hours. So I find that in Malaysia, there are still doors to improve, where we should implement certain rules to balance our work and life. I support ASEAN work-life balance.
I support ASEAN work-life balance.
Work-life balance for ASEAN.